Mga ka-George Sarblocks dyan, pakinggan natin ang sinasabi ni Representative Raul Manuel regarding sa deliberation ng confidential fund ng DepEd, na sinasabi niya na nag-iimbento lang daw ang data ng EAP regarding sa Revel and Revel Returns. So pakinggan natin, mga kababayan, bakit niya sinasabi ito.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Madam Chair, dahil ito ay continuing session ng Committee on Appropriations, I just want to put on record that as a youth representative, I am in a position to question tradition that no longer works and serves as barrier to healthy discussion about allocation and use of public funds. Our tradition of extending parliamentary courtesy stops us in the legislative branch to do our job for which you are paid by the Filipino people. Dapat po may checks and balances tayo. I do not want Congress to be complicit to illegal fund use by agencies in the executive branch. So allow me to put on record also my point of order sa proceedings kanina. Hindi po binila ang boto ng mga nasa dissenting opinion, hindi pinag-explain ng objection. This isn't democracy at work. I condemn the proceedings we had earlier. Traditions that no longer work should be stopped. Now let me proceed to my questions, Madam Chair. Inamin po ng DepEd led by the Vice President na may item dapat sa General Appropriations Act bago magkaroon ng confidential funds. Illegal po kung wala. Now, on the DepEd confidential funds na nasa General Appropriations Act, nabanggit po last year, I can recall, nagagamitin din daw yung confidential funds to stop child grooming, abuse on our learners. May ask po yung data ng DepEd sa paggamit ng confidential funds para masugpo yung ganito. Tapos data din po sa actual cases ng child grooming and other measures para masabi po natin na naging solid yung confidential funds on this matter.
Madam Chair, Yusek po will answer the question.
Thank you, Madam Chair. As to the accomplishments of the Department of Education in the use or with the use of the confidential funds, nagsusumite po tayo ayon sa joint circular sa apat na opisina quarterly as mandated by, again, the guidelines. Doon po tayo nagsusumite sa Office of the President, sa Office of the Speaker of the House, sa Office of the Senate President, as well as doon naman po sa ICFAU or Intelligence Confidential Funds Audit Unit ng COA. Now, of course, those activities are still ongoing pa po. But just to give you siguro po broad strokes, no, kung ano yung mga programa kung saan natin ginagamit yung confidential funds. Number one, it really cuts across yung ano po, no, yung education, basic education. So pagdating po, for example, sa programming ng ating last mile schools, ginagamit po natin yung mga intel.
Madam Chair, I was asking about yung anti-child grooming and anti-abuse na data ng DepEd. Ilan po ba yung mga naging biktima nito in recent years? Tapos ilan yung mga cases na handle ng Department of Education?
Opo, ang masabi po natin, of course, as I mentioned, yung detalye po, sinasubmit natin yan, no, sa apat na opisina. But we found out as to child pornography, no, meron po tayong 20, yung mga website increase from 23,000 to 81,000. And ang average age ng rescue sa ganyan ay around 11 years old. Tayo po ay nakikipag-ugnayan na rin ngayon sa Council for the Welfare of Children. May mga programa po tayong ilulunsad laban sa child grooming at child pornography po.
Madam Chair, para ma-define po natin yung child grooming, ito yung may mga teachers na kinoconsider po na potential dates yung kanilang mga estudyante. Yun po yung tanong ko, Madam Chair. So ilan po ba yung ganon nitong past year? Ilan yung na-handle ng DepEd?
Sa ngayon po, ang ongoing pa lang po, no, na na-handle natin na child grooming case ay yung nasa Cavite po. Yan po ay ongoing na po yung prosecution. And then meron din po sa Zamboanga. So two cases po ang officially na under ng DepEd ngayon.
Madam Chair, to be honest, disappointing po yung sagot kasi sa amin po maraming mga nakakarating na reports kahit sa social media, ang dami. So kung may confidential funds po yung DepEd, kung pagbabatayan yung performance regarding this matter na si Knight last year, wala pong maipakitang magandang performance yung DepEd. Parang dating po sa akin, Madam Chair, nag-iimbento tayo ng dahilan to justify confidential funds. Kahit nga po yung recruitment into rebel groups, quote-unquote, yung data pa po galing sa AFP. Alam natin, nag-iimbento ng data yung AFP pagdating sa rebels and rebel returnees. Kaya for me, Madam Chair, ang dating talaga, tinuturing na prey yung mga estudyante natin. Parang balon ng kriminal yung mga estudyante. Tapos, gina-justify yung confidential fund. Now, while we have budget for confidential fund, Madam Chair, tanong ko naman po on our mental health programs. Saan po sa budget ng DepEd yung specific na para sa mental health programs?
Madam Chair, Asek Galvan will answer the question.
Asek Galvan, you're recognized.
Thank you very much for the question. When it comes to the issue on mental health, this has become a top priority of the Department of Education. As such, it is lodged under our learner support programs, and it is considered one of the major thrusts of the department for the foreseeable future.
So saan po? Kasi maraming mga programs naman yung DepEd, special education, madrasa at iba pa. Pero particular for mental health, since this is mandated by the Mental Health Act.
Yes. It is currently lodged under the Learner Support Program Fund. And it is actually one of the things that we're very thankful to the Congress for, because last year, you were able to accord to us for the first time a special provision fund of 97 million for mental health, which would be benefiting our learners now in this coming school year.
So for this year, magkano yung budget specific for mental health?
Our programs for mental health are intertwined. We have proposed 160 million, particularly for mental health and the improvement of our guidance counseling programs. And this is intertwined with our other programs for substance abuse prevention, adolescent reproductive health, among other youth programs.
Okay, Madam Chair, again, no, I'm alarmed. Mas mataas pa yung budget natin sa confidential funds ng DepEd kesa sa mental health programs, when even DepEd itself has data na almost every day po, trigger warning, may nagpapakamatay na mga basic education students. Mas mataas pa yung bilang ng mga may suicide ideation o yung mga naiisip na kitilin yung sariling buhay dahil sa iba't ibang problema. So, hindi ko magets yung priorities ng DepEd sa ngayon, Madam Chair. Another topic, may data po ba yung DepEd, Madam Chair? Ilan yung estudyante na nasa full face-to-face classes?
Madam Chair, Yusek Escobedo will answer the question.
Yes, good morning, Madam Chair and your honors. Today po, the entire school year 2023-2024, as much as possible ay full face-to-face po tayo, unless kung merong disasters ay naka-blended learning po tayo.
Madam Chair, wala pong data na nabanggit. Kasi may schools pa rin na blended yung kanilang pamamaraan. But last year, ang policy ay face-to-face, so I'm confused. Again po, ilan yung nag-full face-to-face ngayon?
Current po ay 22 million dahil yun ang naka-enroll po ngayon.
How about schools? Ilang schools po yung may full face-to-face class?
All the 47,658 public schools, Madam Chair.
So given that data, Madam Chair, ang dami hindi pa rin pala full face-to-face. Kaya we really should get our priorities straight for DepEd. At kung may wish po ako, Madam Chair, sana wala ng confidential or intelligence funds yung DepEd tsaka OVP. I-realign na po natin yan sa pangangailangan na hindi naman confidential.
Thank you very much, Madam Chair. Thank you very much, Representative Manuel.